All right. Well, here at InfoWars, we have covered a lot of articles on the importance of taking care of yourself, reading the labels, avoiding GMOs. But there are actually FDA-approved drugs out there that you might be taking that are dangerous. People are dying from them. As well, you might be feeding your kids children's supplements, thinking that, you know, they've got to be healthy because they say they're all natural. But they're not. There are some hidden dangers, and pharmacist Ben Fuchs is here to shed some light on the things that we are putting into our bodies. Hi, Ben. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you, Leanne. It's great to be here.
So we've all been distracted with the Zimmerman trial, but while we were all paying attention to what was going on with that, the Supreme Court had a ruling that affects us all.
All right, so Supreme Court rules drug companies exempt from lawsuits. You know, here's the idea. We have a justice system, and we have a political process that's in place that has hoodwinked people into thinking that it's in their interest. So the average person on the street, he'll think that, of course, the Supreme Court and the justice system, they're looking out for the little guy, they're looking out for the average person. Well, when you read articles like this and when you see stories like this in the news, Supreme Court rules drug companies exempt from lawsuits, how is that in the little guy's interest? What that basically means, Leanne, is that if you have a reaction to a prescription drug that you bought as a product, you can't sue the company that made that product. So this is just another reason why people don't want to take things like their health, take things like the health of their family that are so serious and so important and have so much of an impact on how people live their lives, and put it in the laps of people who could care less about whether they live or die. It's just another reason why we have to take our health into our own hands. This is a message I've been talking about for the last 20 years. We have to take our health, the health of our family, into our own hands. And this is really the reason why nutritional supplementation is so important. As a pharmacist, when I read a story like that, what I think is, how about if we just don't take prescription drugs? How about if we just refuse prescription drugs, and instead of using pharmacotherapy, we just use nutritional therapy, we just use food, we just use supplements, we just take care of our health, we just exercise, we just move our bodies around, we just don't interface with processed food, which is another interesting point. Do you know that the same companies that make the drugs, the multinational corporations that do the research and produce the pharmacological agents that we take as medicine, are also behind food processing and food chemicals that are in food and excipients that are in food and flavorings that are in food and perfumes and odor agents that are in food? So we got a system set up where the people who are poisoning us and making us sick are selling us the medicine after we get sick. So what I say is, how about if we just don't interface with the medical model? And how about if we just don't eat the processed food? How about if we eat less food, we make sure we're eating fresh, we make sure we're using nutritional supplements, and we make sure we exercise, and then we don't even have to worry about suing a drug company because they made some kind of poison that created some toxic side effect? Why on earth will we expect the drug companies to be our friends?
Exactly.
Why on earth will we expect the Supreme Court to be compliant with human beings' desires and needs? Why would we expect them to participate in our interest?
Right.
They're the Supreme Court.
Yeah, they already voted to exempt Monsanto from any issues, and now they're trying to regulate what drug trial results can be published.
Right, and the Supreme Court is the same body that decided that corporations were people, that this entity that never dies, that is not accountable to anything but the bottom line, has the exact same rights as you or me, who has to worry about our health and has to worry about our mortality.
Right. You sent me some articles on some dangerous FDA-approved drugs, and they refuse to pull it, even though people are dying.
Well, here's the thing on the drugs. I sent you a couple articles on FDA-approved drug length. You're talking about the 542 deaths and 2,367 hemorrhages, but FDA refuses to pull it. That one is Leanne, let me tell you something. That's one of the best-selling drugs, okay? That's one of the top 10 selling drugs every year, top 20 selling drugs maybe. It's called Pradaxa, and it's a blood-thinning drug. And let me tell you something, the way the body works, the last system you ever want to screw around with is the circulatory system. Pradaxa works by forcing the blood to thin. See, when we get stressed out, when we eat crappy food, when we have emotional and mental problems, or we're taking prescription medicine, our bodies think that our survival is at stake. In fact, this is really the hidden cause of all disease that nobody is talking about. We have developed a culture where the people who live in this culture are walking around in survival mode. Our bodies think that we're about to be eaten by a saber-toothed tiger. See, the human body has two ways of processing chemistry and processing information and living its life. One way it involves thrival and relaxation. That is the ability to grow, the ability to repair, the ability to heal wounds, and it's all tied into relaxation. The second system, the second processing system, if you will, is the emergency processing system. And this emergency processing system, when it kicks in, it shuts down the relaxation and thrival system. The emergency processing system is not designed to heal up, to stimulate healing and to stimulate growth and to stimulate repair. This emergency processing system is designed to do what? To get you the heck away from that saber-toothed tiger. And it takes all of the energy away from growth, all of the energy away from repair, all of the energy away from thinking intelligently, and shunts it over to survival mode. Technically, by the way, this is called the parasympathetic nervous system and the sympathetic nervous system. I just call it the relaxation nervous system and the survival nervous system. Now, praise God we have a survival nervous system, because obviously there's times when you need to survive, when there's some kind of survival threat. But you only want the survival nervous system to be kicking in once in a rare while. For the most part, you want to be running on parasympathetic, relaxation, thrival energy. Well, one of the manifestations of the survival nervous system is blood clotting. When the body thinks that it's about to be eaten by a saber-toothed tiger, and that this really is the main survival threat to the human body doesn't know about survival threats, 21st century survival threats like muggers or the IRS or our dysfunctional families or whatever. The body only knows survival threats that it evolved with, and that's basically being eaten by a wild animal or maybe falling off a cliff. So when the body senses that its survival is being threatened, it will activate the clotting system. Why? In order to keep us from bleeding to death if we get attacked by a lion. So we got people running around in this country, millions upon millions, maybe tens of millions, maybe even hundreds of millions of people who have sludgy, thick blood that is prone to clot because they have been assaulting their body with processed food, depriving their body of oxygen, undergoing all kinds of emotional and psychological threats, taking prescription drugs, drinking polluted water, breathing toxic air. Consequently, our bodies think that we're going to be dying. Our bodies are preparing us for our demise. So we're running around in survival mode. Now, what does this mean? Number one, it means high blood pressure, because that's one of the ways the body handles survival threats. Number two, it means stupidity, because under survival conditions, what ends up happening is energy in the brain gets shunted to our reptilian survival brain and away from our prefrontal cortex, our executive center. And thirdly, for the circulatory system, it means clotting blood. When you have clotting blood, you don't have a drug issue, you have a toxicity issue, and the last thing you want to be doing is putting more toxicity into your body. So let me tell you something, as a pharmacist, I'm not surprised that Pradaxa, which is a 21st century version, a late 20th century version of something called Coumadin, which is also known as rat poison, because that's how you kill rats, is by thinning their blood. That's one of the mechanisms for killing vermin, rodents, is by thinning their blood. Well, guess what? That's what grandma and grandpa, and unfortunately these days, our fathers and mothers are taking as well. Blood-thinning drugs to counteract clotting blood that is thick and sludgy because of toxicity and poor lifestyle choices. So how does Pradaxa work? How does Coumadin work? How do these blood thinners work? They work by saying to your blood, damn it, you are going to thin, and I'm going to make you thin, whether you like it or not. The body doesn't like that. That's not how the body likes to be treated. And so what ends up happening is, instead of having your blood now thin back to normal, you hemorrhage. And instead of being nice and healthy because you took your Pradaxa, you're dead, as 542 people can testify to. And by the way, 542 people, that doesn't sound like a lot of people. But when people take prescription drugs, what they don't realize is they're more prone towards heart attacks. And then they get a heart attack, and they don't attribute it to their prescription drugs. They just figured their heart gave out. And the doctor's certainly not going to tell them it was their prescription drugs. Or if they take their prescription drugs and they end up with liver cancer, because it's the liver that has to process all of these prescription drugs, they don't attribute it to the prescription drugs. They attribute it to just part of being of growing older. So 542 deaths mean 542 people that we know for sure, guaranteed it was the Pradax that killed them. But given, and this is the most important thing when it comes to prescription drugs, Leanne, given the premise, the philosophical idea behind prescription drugs and pharmacological medicine, we cannot help but create a situation where literally 100,000 plus people a year die that we know of from prescription drugs, because you can't force the body to do something it doesn't want to do and not have to pay the price. If you have corporations who don't have ethics, who don't have humanity in mind, who aren't in touch with their own humanity, if they're not in touch with their own humanity, do you think they're going to care about who's buying their product? You know, we can't blame them. That's just who they are. That's just how it is. So when I see stories like aspartame in Flintstones vitamins or in children's vitamins, when I see stories like drug companies can't be sued, when I see stories like the FDA is not our friends, that's just the world we live in, Leanne. And all it means is that people have to wake up, people have to start to participate, people have to be conscious in their own lives, people have to be very careful about how they get information, because you know what? It's an info war, right?
Exactly.
It truly is an info war. That's exactly what it is. You know, the wars today are info wars.
We have to do our own research.
We have to do our own research, and that's why the job you guys are doing over there at InfoWars, hats off to Alex, to you guys, to Rob, to everybody over there who's doing this kind of work, because this is how we are going to win the info war, by having access to all of the information. And that's the beauty of the internet, and that's the beauty of technology, and that's the beauty of the age that's coming up, really. Now, we're on the precipice of something very interesting in terms of human evolution.
Well, Ben, thank you so much. It's been a lot of information. It was a pleasure speaking with you.
Thank you. Hope to speak to you again.
All right. Well, thank you, Ben Fuchs. Now to some other scientists who are playing God. This time it is DARPA, and they are not making killer robots. DARPA to genetically engineer humans by adding a 47th chromosome. The Department of Defense's research arm has just put out a new solicitation for a project called Advanced Tools for Mammalian Genome Engineering. This project isn't just for engineering any mammal's genome, however, it's specifically for the bioengineering of humans. The project's stated objective is to improve the utility of human artificial chromosomes. Ever hear of the term playing God? Well, the scientists who work in these fields not only refer to themselves as genome engineers, but biological designers. They cite Darwin, who described selective breeding as that which enables the agriculturalist not only to modify the character of his flock, but to change it altogether. It is the magician's wand, by means of which he may summon into life whatever form and mold he pleases. Well, they're already altering our DNA with GMOs, so now they're just going to be inserting it directly into our chromosomes. Wow. Well, the U.S. has issued a new travel alert based on a terrorism threat. Current information suggests that Al-Qaeda and affiliated organizations continue to plan terrorist attacks both in the region and beyond, and that they may focus efforts to conduct attacks in the period between now and the end of August. These may involve public transportation systems and other tourist infrastructure. The Department of State has instructed certain U.S. embassies and consulates to remain closed or to suspend operations on Sunday. The airlines are also monitoring the travel situation, and they haven't issued waivers letting passengers rebook flights without paying fees. I wonder how that intel knows that something's going to happen this Sunday, that Al-Qaeda is probably going to be running these terrorist threats till the end of August. That's because the U.S. government runs Al-Qaeda. That's right, Rachel Maddow. You heard it here first. Now, we've been talking a lot about health tonight on the show, so go to InfoWarsHealth.com, and there you can check out all the vitamins and supplements, including Beyond Tangy Tangerine, 2.0. It's delicious. I tried it myself. For the InfoWars Nightly News, I'm Leanne McAdoo. Y'all have a great weekend. Now you can watch The Alex Jones Show live as it happens at InfoWars.com/show.
You'll find links to all of our content there and a free 15-day trial for Prison Planet TV.
More than 60 movies and documentaries all in one place at InfoWars.com/show.